Yeah. Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Baby, I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Baby, we took a trip, now we on your block and it's like a ghost town. Baby, where did these niggas be at?
Baby Shannon, you are tuned into the gray area on Tapped In Media. Make sure you follow me on all platforms. Period.
Welcome to the gray area. It's your boy Noe Alias, and we have a special guest today, the new star of MTV show Ghosted, Baby Shannon. How you doing today, man?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good, man. Blessed to be here. Okay. How about you?
Blessed too.
Okay.
No.
So I want to know, man, first question, what was the casting process like and how long have you been working at it?
We were casted, oh my God, I think it was October of 2019. So we've been working on it for almost a year now. Now they're airing, their season premieres tonight, September 2nd, our episode airs on the 9th. So okay. It's been almost a year.
Almost a year, wow, that's yeah. A long time. So, you know, doing this camera work, you know, seeing the bright lights and everything like that, speaking to the host, was you ever nervous doing any of this? Was it new to you?
I think talking to the host, it was kind of nervous just because you see them on TV all the time and it's yeah. just you don't know how to take them or how they would act in person. I did some extra work on different shows. I did Empire before and stuff, so meeting wow. somebody you see on TV, it's a lot different in person because you're you're a person. So that took some nerves away, but it was still a little nervous.
Wow, okay. So you already knew to this. You're not new to this, as I should say. You
know, I'm true to this.
You're true to this. Okay, let them know.
Not at all.
So I know that the whole season is virtual uh-huh. and you guys were being recorded. How did that go?
Well, it's crazy because like I said, we were working on it for a year and the plan for it was for them to come out to New Orleans. And they were going to film at some of the spots we hang out at, worldwide. Okay. But March came, and that was when they were supposed to come out to Milwaukee. Oh. And that's when COVID started going crazy, and they had to shut down everything, so they hit me up.
COVID hurt a lot of stuff.
Man! And it was salty, okay? So I was just they was this ain't us saying we're not going to follow your story or whatever. They were just we'll hit you up and let you know what we're going to do. And in April, next month, they was we finna send y'all some MacBooks, we finna send you an iPhone, we finna send cameras, whatever you need. We gonna set this shit up and film it from home. So it was cool to watch it all play out, and it actually worked out really well.
Wow. Wait, so going back, I don't know if I heard you correct, so the show wasn't supposed to be completely virtual?
No.
Oh, wow.
The first season was in person. They normally would fly out to wherever you at, and they'll track you down in person. So that's how it was supposed to go, but with this, they had to, compromise?
Yeah, man, wow, that's, yeah. I mean, it's a lot of compromising lately with COVID, so.
Especially in that short amount of time.
So. Yeah, at least y'all were still able to do the show, though.
Definitely.
So this segment, I want to go gray, letting everybody know this is where we ask whatever, you know what I'm saying? The tough questions, whatever like that. So we're going to start it off, man. We're in Milwaukee, and I know that female promoters get a bad rap, so I want to know, why do you think female promoters get a bad rap in Milwaukee?
What do you mean? What do you mean?
They try to say that y'all only work for bottles, try to get in for free. They ain't making money.
They say we work for free.
They say y'all working for free, man. So let them know that y'all ain't working for free or whatever y'all doing, man. Let them know right now, right here.
First and foremost. No, but seriously, I feel that comes from the younger female promoters or hosts. Freshly 21, getting in the club for free and getting
exactly.
free. That's dope as fuck. Freshly 21, you getting, free drinks, your friends getting free. Gone. When you looking for a promoter or something, you looking for somebody who name holds weight, who can bring people in, who has a huge following on Facebook. You not gonna pop out with 10 followers on Instagram and be pay me $3,000 to walk through this motherfucker.
Yeah, exactly.
Bitch, what? So honestly, it's the grind. When you freshly 21, you're building yourself. You're building your face in the community. You know what I'm saying? You're hustling right now, so they can't expect everybody to get paid. That'd be ridiculous.
Y'all heard it here, man. You put in the work.
You put in
you
the
get
work.
The money, man.
And then you start seeing some money.
Exactly. They need to know that, man. Business first.
But I don't do shit free, so don't think that's your
ain't shit free.
You hear me? I ain't put in the work. I've been doing it.
Exactly. Let them know, man. So the next thing I want to ask, do you plan on leaving Milwaukee to pursue your goals? And if you do, when you do make it, is you going to be the type that's going to rep Milwaukee, or are you going to be the type that's like,
I'm going to fuck Milwaukee. Period. Fuck you hoes and all this.
Oh, man. Nah. Cut cameras. Cut it.
Cut that shit. No. But, no, honestly, like, you always got to remember where you come from. No matter if it was, like, tough, rough, or struggle, whatever, like, Milwaukee makes you. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's the grind that makes you. So, like, I always, like, be proud of where I come from, because, like, even though it's tougher than most places, like, you came from that place. So,
yeah,
the goal, honestly, is to get out of Milwaukee, but I'll always visit, like,
show love, you know what I'm saying? Show people the blueprint, how to do it.
That's
it. So, okay, I can rock with that. So this for all the single men out here, or women, whatever you prefer. Here.
I like both of you.
Okay, she like both, so this for both of them. So let them know how they can shoot their shot, man. Any advice for shooting their shot at maybe Shannon, man? What they gotta do? God.
So advice, I was just thinking about this the other day. I like men that are in touch with their feminine side. I'm not saying you gotta be like, you know what I'm saying, super flamboyant or anything, but like, don't come at me trying to be no he-man, woman hater, no manly man, like you just feel like you're finna come step over anything, because then my masculine energy gonna come out and we can really fight. You hear me? Like, I don't like that type of shit. Like, when you like,
on hands.
Yeah, period. No. No, but seriously, like, when you like more like, I don't know how to explain how to say, like, when you like are masculine, but you can show that you can be gentle, like that would cause me to be more submissive, like,
okay.
You know what I'm saying? Women, you know what I'm saying? Like what I like.
All right, so women and men, y'all heard it here, you know what I'm saying? Don't be too masculine, trying to dominate all over.
Right.
And no, you may have that chance. You may have that chance.
You
so,
might get
off camera, you was telling me about MTV now has an Instagram filter for the show Ghosted. Uh-huh. So let's show the people what that's about.
Okay, so there's a filter. Let me unlock my phone. It's called the Ghosted Challenge.
Okay, the Ghosted
Challenge.
Trying
to get into Instagram. It's on Instagram.
It's on Instagram.
So if you go on Instagram and you go where your filters are, I'm taking a picture. Go where your filter are. There you go. So you go to the filter, you put your face in it, and it says Ghosted Challenge. You hold it down, and it gives you a question about being ghosted. So I'm about to see what the question is.
Okay, let them know what that question is. Let them know.
Okay.
And you got to answer it too.
Best first date story. Okay.
And you got to get a worst too, since they gave you that.
Oh!
Just because you're on a gray area, you got to get a best and a worst.
Okay. My best first date story. Honestly, like, it was like a few years ago. Okay. And like, it was literally on like, what was that, Tinder or something? I like,
Tinder?
Randomly, I know.
Maybe should it be on Tinder?
I'll be swiping y'all. No, but no, like, I went out with this guy and I was just like, dude, Tinder, I'm gonna end up dead. Like, I was like, for sure, like, somebody was gonna put me in the trunk, but they didn't. So I think that was more like a surprise, so I was happy about that, not dying and whatnot. But yeah, we ended up going to like a art festival or something random just to go like downtown and walk around and talk and stuff. We went to like a little cafe and like he was so like sweet and like all that. But I was a little younger back then, so I wasn't ready for all that.
Okay. That's how it used to be sometimes. I mean, the ones that's ready for you ain't ready for them.
Definitely. So. He was older than I was. You know what I mean? I was still planning these streets.
So now you gotta let us know what's the worst.
Oh my God.
Give a name if you want to, too. No, we can go to the gray area.
You say what?
Give a name, too.
Oh, no, I cannot, because we're going to be real recent with that. Oh my God. The worst first date. I can't think of a worst. I would hate to say somebody was like the worst, honestly. But I will say, like, I went to some dude's house.
Uh-oh.
I'm like, no, for real, like, on like kind of a first date, like we was gonna chill or something, and I was like, damn, this is literally where it ends at. Like, it just had that like haunted house feel, and I was like, oh God, like what have I gotten myself into now? I didn't die, obviously. Hello.
She's still here, so.
Still here, but it was just like the vibe was really bad. Like, it was just like really weird energy, and again with that toxic masculinity, like he was just like real like on me, and I was like, you don't even know me like that. Like, boy, like, I like when somebody, you know what I'm saying, be chill. Because then you be like,
chill.
It's enough pussy out here, you know what I'm saying? I'm sure you had it before. Damn.
He was that type.
He was that type. Like,
you don't want to get no names, right?
I ain't giving no names. Okay. But chill.
My listeners, do not be like that guy.
Don't be like that guy.
Okay.
Just act like you had some coochie before. That's all women want. Jesus. Act like you've been here.
Have some self-training, man. Y'all have some self-training, man.
Thank you. Show some restraint.
Last but not least, I want you to tell everybody where they can follow you at, all your social sites, so they can get to know Maybe Shannon.
You literally can find me everywhere under Maybe Shannon. Period. Maybe Shannon. On Instagram, I'm Maybe Shannon _. On Facebook, I'm first name Maybe, last name Shannon. On YouTube, I'm Maybe Shannon. On Twitter, I'm Maybe Shannon _. Maybe Shannon everywhere.
All right, so you heard it first. This is the gray area. You tuned in with Maybe Shannon. Life is more than black and white. Let's go gray. Ah!
Period.